Can't you appreciate that Mrs. Wilberforce is not a mere appendage to my plan? She's the very core of it.
Lopsided old grandma.
Yeah. How do we know we can trust her to do it right if she don't even know what she's doing?
One round.
Sweet little old lady like her. Just don't seem right for her to be working with us on a stick-up caper.
Tell you, I don't like old ladies. I don't like having them around. I can't stand them.
You've all become too absorbed. You and your guests might like a cup of tea.
Oh, you shouldn't.
You know, Professor, you didn't tell me the truth about yourself and these other gentlemen. Why, you're not the least bit like amateurs. You really must be professionals. You're every bit as good.
Not quite. Though we are rather proud of Mr. Harvey's tan.
And that pizzicato passage, Mr. Lawson, quite delightful. May I ask you where you studied?
Well, I didn't really study any place, lady. I just picked it up.
You know, I was so surprised when I heard what you were playing. It brought back something that really I'd completely forgotten all about. My 21st birthday party. You see, my father had engaged a string quintet to come in and play in the evening. And while they were playing Boccherini, someone came in and said the old queen had passed away. Then everyone went home. And that was the end of my party. All that time ago, in Pangbourne. Well, if you'll excuse me, I'll run and make the tea. The kettle must be nearly on the boil.
Who's she talking about? Old Queen who?